So I think this may wind up being one of my favorite woods to work with. I mean, I don't know if you can tell, but that is just, there's a lot of sap in there. Call that fat wood at times, or call it fat wood. And that's gonna be nice to strike up and get going. So feathering that all a little bit, it feels a little wet on parts of that. So I'm gonna go ahead and split this on down, try to see if I can get into some drier stuff. With knife safety there. Baton this on down, but anyway, yeah, there's just nice sap in there, so this is gonna light up really well. May even save some of that to throw in my kit. The Adventure IQ out doing some work with Trigger and Abby today. Gotta get a tarp set up for the night. Gotta get all this wood split up and set up. Doing another split wood fire. Today's split wood is brought to us by Ponderosa Pine. So I think this is split wood number 5, 6 maybe, I don't know, four or five or six. We've just been doing quite a few. Had some split wood experiments that did not work out yesterday, and that was trying to use apple and cherry. Couldn't do a split with that wood with them because first of all, it was about this big around, and that wood is incredibly hard, so something I learned. I never even tried to burn it before. Could not even split it. I tried hatchets, I tried batoning with the old standby, couldn't get it to go, so I think that's gonna make really good smoker wood. Anyway, I gotta finish getting the rest of this wood process, get the fire lit. Abby's got some things that she's gonna accomplish on this outing, and then I've got to redo my tarp. I got all excited last time and used my my brand new BC USA tarp and had completely forgot about it being a improvised tarp. Anyway, so here we go. Alright, so as I said before, today we're using Ponderosa Pine. What I do when setting this up, first of all, I baton everything down. Split wood, if you've got wet wood or you know damp conditions, anything like that, split wood is gonna light a lot faster for you than trying to light a great big log or something, correct? Gets us a chance to burn our fuel in a more efficient manner. It keeps the fire low. What I've done is I've got 3 times the amount of firewood here than I do over here. This is how I'm going to start the fire. We all know that sometimes fire doesn't get going the way it should. We've got to coax it along. Also, I want to have firewood ready and waiting for me so I can get warm. I don't want to start a fire then have to go out and find more firewood. So you get all of your materials first. The component. These are all shavings off the wood that's been splitting today. So I'm going to use this as my initial tinder. And by the way, I do have pine right there. I'm going to try not to use that today. Might have to. The other thing is, I've set up a brace. I'm going to light my fire right in here. The wind is actually coming from this direction. This is going to do two things. One is it's going to help protect my initial flame. But then as this starts burning, I'm gonna add wood to this side. And of course, with the wind coming from the opposite direction, it's going to allow the wind to breathe oxygen onto that fire. So first it's gonna protect, and then bringing the wind across, it's gonna help to build that flame. So all the wood will be stacked on this side. This is a great brace log, by the way. It's got a lot of, I wasn't able to baton this one down. It's just too rough. And this is one of the reasons why. Look at all that sap that's down in there. So I tried turning the log to see if we could use that sap to our advantage, and just didn't work out. So we're gonna go ahead and go with it just like this. Now the shavings are starting to burn, and now we're gonna start adding our pencil lead size and our pencil size wood to the fire. I'm gonna use the pine needles. The pine needles are actually damp. I wouldn't say wet, but they are damp. So what I'm doing right now is I'm making char cloth, and this is just denim off a pair of pants that Abby had turned into some shorts. And this is cotton. Actually makes pretty good charring material. Now we use this for lighting fires either with a striker such as a Light My Fire, or you can use the traditional flint and steel or Chertin steel. So I always like having some of this on hand. Lately I've been really interested in finding what natural materials with char. And I'm still doing those experiments. But at the same time, I want to have something that I know is going to light for me. And that's why I'm cutting this up. And then I'm going to put it into a tin and throw in the fire and make some good charred material for lighting fires. Oh, smoky! That's one thing about this fire. It has been a really, really smoky fire. It's going to make tonight.